So in this question, a single phase half wave rectifier is charging a battery, it is an RE load. So in this case, thyristor will be forward biased only when supply voltage is more than the battery voltage of E volts. So that means from in between theta 1 and theta 2, you can see supply voltage is more than the battery voltage, here thyristor is forward biased. Then in the next cycle, from theta 2 up to 2 pi plus theta 1, from here to here, the battery voltage E volts, this E is dominating the supply. So wherever E is more than the supply voltage, thyristor is reverse biased. So what is circuit turn off time? So in this case, thyristor stops at theta 2. So from theta 2, we have to find circuit turn off time. What is circuit turn off time? How much time reverse voltage is applied across the thyristor? When thyristor stops at theta 2, thyristor is reverse biased up to 2 pi plus theta 1. When thyristor stops at theta 2, it is reverse biased up to 2 pi plus theta 1. So this duration is circuit turn off time. So from that, we can find the circuit turn off time. Omega TC is equal to 2 pi plus theta 1 minus theta 2. So 2 pi plus theta 1. So we have to express theta 2 in terms of theta 1. So this angle is pi radians. So theta 2 is pi minus theta 1. This value is theta 1. So it is pi minus theta 1. So from this you can write pi plus 2 theta 1. So this is omega TC. So circuit turn off time is pi plus 2 theta 1 by omega seconds. So theta 1, how to calculate this theta 1? At theta 1, supply voltage, battery voltage are equal. So theta 1 is sin inverse E by Vm. So E value is given, sin inverse 100 by Vm is 230 into square root of 2. So after calculating, you will get theta 1 value 17.9 degree. Substitute here, you will get pi plus 2 times of theta 1 is 17.9 degree. But here theta 1 should be expressed in radians. So convert into radians. Radians means into pi by 180 degrees. So pi plus 2 theta 1 by omega. Omega is 2 pi into frequency is 50 hertz. So after simplifying this, you will get the answer is 11.99 milliseconds.